Hey everyone, Brian here, and when you think of Europe, what comes to your mind? Is it the Eiffel Tower in Paris? Or is it the Colosseum of Rome? Or maybe you think of enjoying some fresh seafood by the beach, gazing over the calm, clear waters of the Mediterranean Sea. Chances are that you associate one or more of these scenes with the European experience. So today, let's take a field trip to one of the most popular and most beautiful parts of Europe, the Southwest. Our objectives today are to be able to identify the countries of southwestern Europe, and also to identify the land characteristics, bodies of water, and climate. Location. If you want to find southwestern Europe on a map, just look for the peninsulas. Oh, we mentioned before that Europe is a continent of peninsulas, right? It is, so focus in on the ones that touch the Mediterranean Sea. Southwestern Europe contains 9 countries. Portugal, Spain, and Andorra on the Iberian Peninsula, France and Monaco directly to the north, Italy, San Marino, and Vatican City on the Italian Peninsula, and the tiny island of Malta in the Mediterranean Sea. Yes, you may have noticed that almost all of these countries are on a peninsula. The only major country that isn't is France. It's the largest country in the region, just smaller than Texas, and it has been referred to as the bridge between northern and southern Europe. What's more, France has many cultural ties to Western Europe. Ooh la la! For our lesson, we will be giving France a home in southern Europe. Très bien! Now, there is a reason why the Eiffel Tower and the Roman Colosseum may come to your mind when you think of Europe. That's because European culture has had a tremendous influence on the Western world. From the ancient Romans, who built the Colosseum nearly 2,000 years ago, to France's Eiffel Tower, relatively young, circa 1889, the world has long marveled at European art, architecture, and design. These landmarks have come to represent the cultures which created them and the continent on which they reside. But before you grab a baguette and watch the lights of La Tour d'Eiffel twinkle, or put on your gladiator's helmet and pretend that you're fighting in the Colosseum, let's find out more about the region they're located in, southwestern Europe. The land. You already know that southwestern Europe is a land characterized by peninsulas, creating many long, meandering coastlines. There are over 5,000 miles of shoreline in Italy alone. In addition, the land itself is quite fragmented. From small hills up to massive mountain ranges, there are an abundance of natural barriers that, in times past, made travel difficult. As a result, southwestern Europe developed distinctive pockets of regional and local culture, even during times dominated by massive empires such as the Romans. Because of these nuanced cultures, on your pasta tour of Italy, you can taste penne in Campania, bigoli in northern Veneto, and strozzapreti, meaning priest strangler, in Bologna. On second thought, you may want to let someone else have your strozzapreti. Microstates. These isolated communities have even resulted in the formation of several microstates today. A microstate is a sovereign country with a very small land area or population. There are 6 microstates in Europe, and 5 of them are in the southwest. They are Andorra, Monaco, San Marino, Vatican City, and Malta. The largest of these in land area is Andorra, at just under 200 square miles. It is 2/3 the size of New York City, and with less than 1/100th of its population. The Alps. So now we know that land barriers have contributed to isolation in southwestern Europe. And one of the most distinctive dividing lines between central and southern Europe is none other than the world-famous Alps mountain range. Created by the merging of the African and Eurasian tectonic plates, the Alps stretch across 8 countries for 750 miles and feature spectacular snow-capped vistas. Mont Blanc, on the border of France and Italy, is the highest mountain in the Alps, reaching a height of 15,778 feet. Now, don't worry if you can't make it there. You can check out 127 other alpine peaks, which surpass 13,000 feet. Other mountain ranges. South of the Alps is the Apennine Range, stretching the length of the Italian peninsula. The most famous member of the Apennines is Mount Vesuvius, a volcano that famously erupted in 79 CE and destroyed the town of Pompeii, but yet perfectly preserved many of its inhabitants in ash. Forming a natural border between France and Spain, the Pyrenees stretch from the Atlantic Ocean to the Mediterranean Sea. While not as dramatic as the Alps, the highest point in the Pyrenees is 11,168 feet, these mountains remain quite formidable. Rivers, lakes, and seas. Rivers and lakes. Drainage from the Alps and other mountain ranges has created quite a few rivers throughout southern Europe. However, they are shallow and largely unsuitable for shipping or transportation. Nonetheless, southern Europeans have decided to go with the flow and use rivers such as Spain's Tagus and Italy's Po as sources of hydroelectric power. The region features few lakes except at the foot of the Alps, but the ones they have, like Lake Como, are certainly nothing to be ashamed of. The Mediterranean Sea. The most well-known body of water associated with this part of the world is the famous Mediterranean Sea. The Mediterranean is so well-known, in fact, that it is the world's leading tourist destination, with one-third of the world's international tourists, over 300 million people, visiting each year. That's right, one out of every three people who cross borders for a vacation in a given year are going to the Mediterranean. Why is that? Because, of course, Mare Nostrum, or Our Sea, as the Romans called it, is beautiful. From picturesque sea cliffs to relaxing beaches to charming fishing villages, the Mediterranean is the ultimate place to relax. The climate. The Mediterranean attracts visitors not only because of its physical beauty, but also because of the climate that it contributes to. In fact, the prevailing weather pattern in southwestern Europe is referred to as the Mediterranean climate. This climate features dry, hot summers and cool, damp winters. If you go to visit the Mediterranean during the summer months, you may go for your entire vacation without seeing a single cloud in the intensely blue sky. And even if you go in winter, you likely won't encounter any freezing temperatures, so don't pack too many warm clothes. The Mediterranean climate contributes to the prevalence of scrub vegetation. This type of vegetation is drought-resistant, but also susceptible to fires in the dry climate. The Atlantic Ocean. Another major body of water in southwestern Europe is the Atlantic Ocean. While Portugal does not touch the Mediterranean, it has plenty of Atlantic coastline and also enjoys a Mediterranean climate. Spain and France have coastal areas on both the Atlantic and the Mediterranean, and the two coastal regions are much different. Northwestern France, on the Atlantic, features a maritime climate with rainy, cool weather. This part of France gets over 200 days of rainfall each year, and summer days average only about 60 degrees. On the other hand, the French Riviera on the Mediterranean is warm, sunny, and dry, just like everywhere else on the sea. Boring. Climate and the Alps. On the other hand, the mountains can feature a colder alpine climate with year-round snow in altitudes over 10,000 feet. Believe it or not, the Alps also contribute to the Mediterranean climate in the south. When the winds come from northern Europe and reach the Alps, they are forced to rise and water vapor in the clouds condenses. This results in more rain on the windward side of the mountain, the side that the wind blows from. Once the wind blows over the mountains, the water vapor is gone, resulting in warm, dry air. This phenomenon, as you learned in a previous lesson in the course, is called the orographic effect. The same happens with the Pyrenees, which keeps the Iberian Peninsula warm and sunny. Conversely, when the Sirocco wind comes across Italy, the Alps stop it in its path, trapping the heat. So, there you have it, the physical features of southwestern Europe. And as far as physical features go, you could do a lot worse. I suppose if you hate endless sunshine, stunning beaches, crystal clear water, fresh pasta, oh, and also world-class wine, maybe in a few years, this may not be the place for you. As for the rest of us, we may not be ready to return from our field trip. And can you blame us? The good news is, we'll be returning to southwestern Europe in the lesson Southwest Europe, People and Culture. Until then, au revoir, arrivederci, and hasta luego. Seguir explorando! Hey!